Welcome to Cocktails and Conversation. Baby, it is the season finale, but don't fret, because we still got a hot show for you tonight, okay? Yes, we have Spenser Hunt. Yes, he's part of a little of a 225 Pro Wrestling, but he got some other stuff going on that we're gonna check out a little bit later. Also, you know I got a good old cocktail for y'all. It's the final countdown, okay? And you'll see what's in that later as well. Also, you know, I'm gonna come with the CorNae-ism. And of course, you know, we gotta go see my girl KC on the block. Yes, it's KC's corner, but now it's the whole block. She monopolized. She passed go. She get $200, okay? That's what we doing. Also, you know, y'all gotta sit back, relax, chill, and let me just do my thing, because it's the season finale, baby, so, you know. Go put your little warmers on, put your socks on, whatever you gotta do to get cozy and wozy before you go to the mosey, because cocktails is going down, okay? Right after these commercials. Cocktails, a conversation. Y'all know what time it is. It's the final countdown. We got our last drink of the season. And you know how to go out with a bang and put all them things up in there, because it's a party. You know, that's what we came here to do. That's what we're going to do. This is called Final Countdown. We're going to start with a little Old Foster. That's whiskey. You know, that song been playing in my head a lot. Whiskey, whiskey. You know, I can't sing, but anywho. So I said, let's double up on the whiskey today, okay? We're gonna have a little Old Foster with a little bit of that good old Maker's Mark, okay? And then, you know, I've been floating all season. So we're gonna put a little Espolòn on float, okay? And a little cherry juice. And also, I don't know if these are like special edition, but this one tastes great, and it is strawberry / apricot. Now, when the last time you had an apricot? Think about that. It's been a long time, man. That's all I can say. So let's dive into this drink. I got my shakers today. Don't toss that thing like that, okay? Well, let me go ahead and put some ice in my glasses. Okay, and make sure you fill it up, because, you know, once the alcohol hit, baby, it's gonna melt, okay? Now, I'm gonna go ahead and put my drinks in here first before I put my ice, just so, you know, we won't go overboard. But anywho, let's start with this Old Foster. I forgot about Ruby Red over here, y'all. Yeah, we're gonna just to cut it just a little bit, because two whiskeys is a lot, okay? So Old Foster, you know, two gas equals, you know, however many shots. It doesn't matter. But since we got a lot of alcohol, I'm gonna keep it light, okay? Shot for each person. Let's go ahead and drop in on a Maker's Mark. Dang, come on. Now I'm gonna use a shot glass and be a lady and be very demure, yeah, okay? And for my other cocktailers out there who wanna make sure they don't spill nothing, just go ahead and pour it. All that trying to look is just gonna drip down your arm and everything else, okay? Anywho, next we got a little bit of that strawberry apricot energy drink. And I'm not measuring it. I'm just gonna lightly put that in there, okay? A little ruby red, because I said we're going to cut it a little bit. And I'm not measuring that either. That's on you, okay? You don't need much, though, okay? You don't want to cut it out and make it all ruby red, okay? And then last but not least, you want a little cherry juice, just to make it nice, fun, and summery. All right, we don't want it too sweet, because I'm not that type of girl, okay? I'm actually kind of like, you know, sour. Okay, add your ice and shake them up. And be careful because I forgot the last time I had some with carbonation in it. It splats everywhere, so make sure you're holding it tight. And shake that thing right. Oh yeah, it's ready. And I was gonna put it, but I'm just gonna show you guys. Just go ahead and pour it on top. That's a nice color. And if you wanna get fancy dancy, go ahead and put a little cherry on that thing, you know. Pop that cherry, you know. Put it on up there. Man, little Espelon, you know, I told you we floating, been floating all season. So why not floating? I'ma measure it. I hadn't been measuring, but this is the final. So we're gonna keep it classy and demure. Float. And see, when you float the alcohol on top, you give it time to simmer on down, you know, while you're drinking it, because as soon as you stick that straw in, you know, you suck it from the bottom. Should be sucking from, I mean, you know, you suck from the bottom. You know what I get, you know what I mean. Last but not least, who's ready to drink? Right after these commercials.
A show that didn't make it on the list of places not to take a first date. A show that needs money so bad that it's about to start an OnlyFans page.
So about the PPP loan.
To a show that wonders why Jonathan Majors is always poking his lips out.
It was that youngest child who helped me in law school.
I promise you, it's really funny.
Hello and welcome back to KC's Corner. Today we're going to talk about face mapping. Now, there are several kinds of face mapping that can be done. One would be Ayurvedic face mapping. You have the traditional Chinese face mapping. And the difference in these types of mapping is that one is used to identify what is going on inside your body, i.e. your stomach or your small intestines, your bladder. Yes, your face can let us know those things. If you have breakouts or irritation in your cheeks, perhaps. You know, these are different signs of issues that are going on inside. So, now, this is not something that you're gonna have to figure out yourself. Of course not. You could come to Phoenix Heir Spa, and when we do your consultation, I'll go over your skin, we'll take a look at it through the scope and do the face mapping so that I can see if you're having hormonal issues, perhaps, or if you may be having breakouts from products or gel around your hairline. The breakouts in your cheeks could be from toxins in your body. So until next time, take care of yourself and take care of each other. See you soon.
As you can probably tell, we are too young to vote.
But that doesn't mean we aren't up on serious issues.
Like the ones that affect everyday people, which is why we need the right person on the bench.
And our dad is the best.
But his campaign needs help to win.
Our dad is always working hard helping people. So come on, people, let's help him.
Go to this link or scan this QR code.
Let's put the best on the bench.
Support our dad's campaign.
Welcome back to Cocktails of Conversation. Y'all know I keep the hottest of the hot of guests. And today, baby, we got Spenser Hunt in the building. Spenser.
CorNae, what's going on?
You know what it is over here. I'm jelling.
I think I came to have a good time.
I think so too. And I think that's what we're going to do today because I hooked up us a drink. I don't know if you want to drink it right now. You want to go ahead and take
it? Let's do it. It's the final countdown, right?
This is the final. You got to do this when you do it.
Final countdown. Okay, yeah. I don't think either one of us should be in a chorus. But
okay, no.
That's all right.
All right. You ready to dive into this thing?
After you.
Here we go, y'all.
You're trying to kill me?
I'm trying to kill myself. What in the world did I make? We gotta drink this slow, like.
I don't know that you want to keep it around that long. You know what it made me think?
That whiskey is whiskey.
Good no, God. No, you know what it is? When's the last time you had an apricot?
It's been years. I didn't know what an apricot looked like. No.
Well, y'all want
to. Damn it, I don't know what it tastes like either. And it don't go with strawberry.
Mm. It's really not bad. The longer you sip on it, I think, the better it gets.
It's almost like it's on the mule side without the ginger.
Yes.
It's got that little funny, but it's gonna do the job.
Mm-hmm. It's gonna work just fine.
Anywho, it ain't all about the cocktails. It's about you, baby, okay? Let the people know exactly, you know, who you are affiliated with, because we already had one guest that, you know, you're very close to, so.
Yeah, earlier this season, which, by the way, thank you for having me for the season finale. What an honor to be here.
Save the best for season. I'm not even going to say that because you're trying to get me in trouble.
Only a little bit. I'm not going to judge the rest of your guests. I'll just judge CJ Goodspeed, who you had prior this season.
But yeah, best for last. You know, it's nothing personal.
No. It's just business.
It's just business.
That's right. Okay. Yeah. So I lead a weird life, but it's a lot of fun. I think the two main things that I do are that I work with Pro Wrestling 225, right? Just like CJ Goodspeed did.
Yes.
But I also am a co-owner of Suspense Games, which is a live game show company here in town.
Live game, let me process this.
Yeah.
Live game show company.
Mm-hmm.
When was it established?
I was a teacher first for a while, right? So 2019, 2020, I was teaching, and I just knew that it wasn't what I wanted.
Okay.
Right? And so, surprise, surprise.
FTK, that means the key. Okay, no more teaching.
Well, it's really FTSS, the school system.
Oh!
But that's a whole other conversation. Yeah. But anyway, so during the pandemic, I had some extra time while I was teaching, and so the idea sprouted. How can I make a real-life game show like you see on TV something you can do in your own backyard? And that's kind of where we started.
So you say bringing it to your backyard, like, how does that work? Like, are y'all, like, rentable? Like, hey, come out, set it up.
Yes. Yeah, the idea is you can book us for corporate events or birthday parties or anything you want, right? Because we want really to deliver that experience that you watch on TV for any event that really just wants to have fun. I've decided at this point in my life, I'm not doing anything unless it's fun. Okay. That's why I'm here tonight.
Hey.
So
we're going to have some fun.
Exactly.
I'm a fun girl. So when you say games, like, what kind of games you got?
Okay, so first of all, during the week, we do restaurant trivia, right? So you can go at 9 different locations around town,
mm-hmm.
Monday through Thursday, we're there setting up, we have a game going on, just for you to have while you're having dinner, right? Chance to win prizes, that's okay. All week long.
What kind of prizes?
Well, gift cards, typically for the restaurants, you know? So I refuse to play a game without a prize, because what's the point? What's the point? That's what people want to know. What am I winning? Right, bragging rights can only go so far. So that's during the week, and then our game show is a game show that we built ourselves. It's called Suspense. It's sort of a good mix between Family Feud and Jeopardy, but it's not built to be difficult.
It's trivia.
It's not hard trivia. There's 10 answers to every question. You've got a teammate with you the whole time. You would be great at it.
I think I would, because I think outside the box.
Who would your perfect teammate be? If you could bring anybody with you, who would it be?
I have a few.
Okay.
I mean, it's just like, you know, you gotta have a team. It's a bad game, baby.
I'm still waiting on my t-shirt.
Who's in charge of that?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yes, I would choose Mad Game and, you know, a few other people, but as far as the games, like, how long are they, like?
Yeah, so it just kind of depends on what is, right? So if you need something that's just 45 minutes to an hour, we got you. But if you want something that sort of encompasses 2 to 3 hours, we can do that too. We've done events for 10 people. We've done events for 1,000 in the PMAC. So it just kind of depends. We're more than happy to accommodate whatever is going on. You know, I was thinking about because it's Suspense Games, right? So there's multiple games. We want to expand and do anything that we can. One of the things I've been thinking about a lot is, you ever seen the show Big Brother?
Yes.
We need a Baton Rouge Big Brother, don't you think? Could you imagine being locked in a house with these people?
No. We got different, well, I don't know. Okay. See, on Big Brother, you know, they get people from all around the world. You probably get all the people from Baton Rouge or like all the people from Louisiana?
I think it could be interesting.
Where you gonna miss something? See, that's what I mean. Like,
there is not a strong enough waiver, probably, to sign to play that game.
Occasions. Too many Hicks, too many Hunts.
But do you think you'd be good at a game like that?
Yeah, I mean, I think so. Come on, be part of my team, girl. You know, you got, like a heck. I watched it, but I really don't get it. Like,
I mean, you're just it's sort of like Survivor, right? You're voting people off the island the whole way.
Right.
You're voting
you
people out of the house.
For just
until the end. Until the end. Last man standing.
Tic tac toe.
You get it. You get it. I think you would be captivating to watch on Big Brother. Don't you think?
I have no idea. Maybe. I don't know.
You might be something worth thinking about.
Well, go ahead and put it together. Okay. I'll be one of your contestants.
That is what I do. So, perfect. I'm in.
Well, we're going to dive more into Spence and see what he got going on, baby, after these commercials. Back to Cocktails and Conversations, baby. We got Spencer Hunt on the scene with the gangster lean. How you doing, Spencer?
I'm good, Corey. Getting better the more this drink happens.
Okay, it really does. And you gotta stop laughing at me because I just get more like, everything I'm saying, giggling over here is making me.
We're having a good time.
It's good.
Season finale. We should be having Come on.
Felt like my thing. Anywho, let's get back to this game talk, okay? Mm-hmm. So, who is the host when, you know, putting on the shows? Like, do y'all designate somebody or?
Yeah, that's a great question. It's me. We have a team of three owners, right? And so one guy is the tech. This is Robert. And so he's the one that builds.
Rob.
The hero of everything, right? He's the one that builds the show around you. Tyler is our physical set person. So he builds all our physical set props and stuff, right? So he, again,
he's
helps
the man
you.
With the hand.
Right, which is definitely not me.
Okay.
And so I'm the one that comes in, I write the trivia, and then I host the games myself.
Oh, you're the smart, handsome one.
Well, I'm just the one that's not good at anything else.
Well, you're good at this because, you know, you've been doing good this whole show.
Thank you.
I barely even have to do anything. Like, go ahead, take it away, Spence! No. Okay. So, what would one of these hosting of this game show cost?
Yeah, listen, that's a great question, too.
And we all got insurance. You never know when a fight might break out.
Well, listen.
I'm competitive.
The last thing we want is...
You better not say no dumbass answer. I'm just playing.
I could see it, and I want it. And I want it so badly.
Yeah, I am a lover, not a fighter, y'all. Don't believe that. I just be playing.
When the Baton Rouge Big Brother idea came to mind, you know you were top of the list for me.
Really?
100%.
I really didn't think I would be top of the list.
100%. So I'm just, you know, we'll get back to that later. But yeah, it depends on what you're booking us for, right?
I would have been Johnny.
Listen, we love Johnny Hustle.
We love Johnny Hustle. Too. I love him so much.
I'm waiting to get him in the wrestling ring first.
I really want to see that because I think Johnny would be a great wrestler.
I think he'd be a great wrestler. I think he'd really,
big at the top, little at the bottom. That's my boy. What's wrong with y'all?
So, to answer your question.
That works in his benefit. Y'all don't even know, okay?
It depends on...
What's for his benefit?
That's not what I heard. So,
you don't... Well, let me shut up, baby. We got company. Come on.
So, to answer your question, if you're booking us for like a restaurant-style game,
okay, restaurant
right? So,
style.
If you're coming in, we're just playing some trivia, hanging out, taking it easy. It's $225 a night. And so that, yeah, it's super affordable, especially when you're trying to host a restaurant with 100 people there.
10 people with
a... Nothing to it. When you get to the game show, we're thinking full production, right? We bring in our whole set. We got the lights, the sound, the whole thing. Mm-hmm. And so that runs closer to $600 or $700, depending on how long the event
is. That's for those corporate events.
It's for those corporate events. It's absolutely for those corporate events. But again, if you have a good birthday party and you want to split it between friends, it's super doable that way too.
Right.
We want it to be both affordable, but also just really fun. And we don't want to slack on production just because it's affordable, right?
What's your availability since you're the host and, you know, you can't be everywhere at once?
I sure can't. I have a pretty busy schedule. My Google Calendar is a scary, scary place. But
Halloween!
Halloween!
Apricot. Keep it together.
Listen, I got it. We're fine.
We're good.
Availability, super open all the time. Everything's fine.
Okay.
Now, really, we can make it work, right? So we do a lot of events around the holidays for Halloween.
I was about to ask
for example.
Do you work on holidays?
Absolutely. We've done a game on Thanksgiving Day. We've done games on Christmas Eve, on New Year's Day, whatever. We know those are when the parties and the events are happening and you're getting together with your family or whatever it might be. So, yeah, we're super open.
So, for the future, are you, are you going to, like, franchise or anything? I mean, because, you know, we just in Baton Rouge. You know, what if Shreveport wants this type of entertainment?
Yeah, well, and they should. They should want this kind of entertainment.
You know,
yeah.
Branch on me like, you do this, and this how it goes.
I think the...
Here's my money.
The trivia side of things is super franchisable, right? So, right now, I actually have a game that happens in San Diego every week.
Mm-hmm.
I have a teacher that I used to work with that lives in San Diego now, and he hosts the Spenser Games trivia once every 2 weeks.
Okay.
So, super franchisable. I can just send you the information, right? And we make it happen. But in terms of the game show itself, we're looking into a brick and mortar, having an actual building so you can come to our space and have some fun with us
that
way.
Okay.
Exactly.
Well, that's great.
Yeah.
I'm not on Twitter.
No, that's okay.
X-rated over there. I don't even mess with that.
Are we talking about Johnny Hustle again?
Oh, you brought it back. Bring it back. Oh. That's why he said.
Yeah, our website.
This is my boy. I'm just saying. My ninja. Who's ninja? Mine. And I'll second that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Social media.
When was the last time you had an apricot?
Really?
Really? I mean,
it's been years.
Mm.
I don't even think about apricots.
I can't think of the last time I thought about an apricot.
Today, I bet somebody gonna eat an apricot.
I bet, just because of you. Because of you. What was that one more time?
Apricot. Okay, well, Spence, you know, I had a great time.
Me too. Thanks for having
me. I know you don't leave me either. But we gotta go, baby. We got bills to pay, okay?
Yeah, me too, girl.
Okay. Well, we'll be right back after these commercials. Cocktails conversation. Y'all know what time it is, baby. It is CorNae-ism, and you might say, what is a CorNae-ism? That could be a word, it could be a phrase, it could be whatever come out these lips. So today for our final CorNae-ism, we have PPD. It's like PPD. Post-party depression, because this is a party right here on Cocktails that I don't want to end, and I think I'm gonna have PPD. I'm gonna get depressed. I'm not gonna be able to talk to y'all. I'm not gonna be able to see y'all. But until I come back. Because I'm coming back. Regardless, they try to take me off the air or not, okay? It's going down. But yes, that is CorNae-ism for the show is PPD, post-party depression. And we'll be right back after these commercials. Thank you.
up? This is your girl, Megan Good, and I want to give a shout out to Mad Game ENT.
Welcome back to Cocktails. Y'all know what time it is. It's the end of the road, the final countdown. We gotta go, but not really, but kinda, maybe. I'm gonna ask for them to extend the show or something. Y'all wanna keep seeing me? No? What about Johnny? No? I ain't think so. I'm just playing. I love him. I love everybody in Mad Game. Oh my God. It's him, y'all. Give it up. It's the Johnster. It's my boy. I just be playing with him, but it's all love, baby. We're gonna take us a little shot.
Since you just put me on this, what is this?
Reposado.
I hope I got enough.
You got enough. Drown it out. Yeah.
Drain that thing, huh?
Mm-hmm. Drain it. Oh, you drained mine, cuz. Hold on.
I gotta get a little closer.
It went through my nose. Anywho, cheers to the end. I wouldn't be able to do it without Mad Game and everybody associated with it. We gonna love y'all, we gonna miss y'all, but hope y'all enjoyed everything. Hope you enjoyed my guest, Spenser Hunt. Also, I hope you enjoyed the cocktail, cause baby, it got me lit 100, okay? Also, I hope you check on KC over there. You know my girl had everything over there on the block, cause it stay hot. And I hope you enjoyed the CorNae-ism. And we gonna miss y'all. We out.
PPD.
PPD. Post-party depression. I'm getting it right now. I'm feeling it. Let me out. Let me out, dog. All the good tips on how to keep it taut. Keep it taut. Woo! So somebody put that out there in the air and I caught it. And it's been in my nose ever since. Okay.
Pick Catch CorNae in the ring next year for pro wrestling.
Okay, I wanna be like, but I wanna be like, Ric Flair.
Duh.
All that.
You need a Woo! You need a robe.
I need a Rolly.
Woo!
Woo! Rolex wearing. Gucci flip-flops carrying.
Jet flying.
Jet flying. Ass cheek flapping. Woo! I can't take my drink. The final countdown. We got a wristlet. Thank you.